What you have given me is the most profound experience I can imagine. I'm so filled with emotion about what just happened. It's extraordinary. I hope I never recover from this. I hope that I can maintain what I feel now. I don't want to lose it.
Wow, that was actor William Shatner describing his experience of being part of the Blue Origin's flight to the edge of space more than 50 years after he made his debut as the beloved Star Trek character, Captain James Kirk. Shatner at 90 is the oldest person to go into space. The flight lasted 10 minutes and was Blue Origin's second crewed mission. Joining us now, Neil deGrasse Tyson, astrophysicist and director of the Hayden Planetarium in New York. You guys are friends. I'm going to put up a picture of you and William Shatner. Have you talked to him since, or can you talk about what was on his mind today?
Well, we're not beer drinking buddies, but we're strong acquaintances, I would say. What I can tell you is that when we think of sort of the Right Stuff era of astronauts, where there were these sort of people where there's no emotion in what they said, and they were just all sort of science and engineering, and now we send up a beloved actor, and in other missions we've sent up basically one of us, people who we care about, people who could live up the street. And it is a reminder that maybe a position of privileged view, it's a position where we all would have access to take that glance at Earth that we wouldn't otherwise ever be able to see.
Our family, we are consumers of everything you create. We are regulars at the Hayden Planetarium. And, you know, you look at the way young people, especially young children, view the planet. It's still sacred to them. They don't take it for granted. They don't. Plastic bottles aren't a thing they see. They're not a thing they grab at the market. I wonder if you can just talk about, you know, aside from a beloved actor taking this extraordinary trip, just talk about the importance of what you just said. Space becoming accessible, becoming all of our backyard, to solving the problems of the planet.
Well, think about what would happen if we started sending poets and artists and journalists, people who have access to different branches of civilization. And what would then happen is, for our culture, where we all become participants, even if it's only vicariously. And one of the advantages when you ascend Earth, and you see how thin the atmosphere is. Mm-hmm. You'd say, oh my gosh. All right, the atmosphere is to Earth what the skin of an apple is to an apple. And so that's kind of, you realize that. Then, of course, there are no color-coded countries such as what we've been trained to look at in the schoolroom globe of our social studies class. All of a sudden, Earth becomes one. And in these tribalistic, divisive times, I think we need that more than ever.
Yeah, I'm feeling this uncommon sensation of hope. Would you like to see teachers up there so they can come back and bring this to life in classrooms?
Yeah, I mean, I think teachers, what we could also do is make sure there's some sort of whatever is the minimum age, I think they said 18, we could start grooming middle school kids and say,
yeah,
who's going to be the next 18-year-old to go into space? And then Teen Beat can follow them. Are they eating well?
Yeah. Oh, I love that.
Just imagine if it becomes a participatory culture. And so, yeah, definitely teachers so that they can share that life experience. And one day we wouldn't have to share the experience because everyone would have had access. And you didn't ask, but I want to slip in here the concern that this is the billionaire's boys race, right? And, you know, the dawn of aviation, only rich people flew on airplanes, all right, because it was expensive and it was kind of novel. And if you're novel and expensive, rich people do it, all right? But that birthed an entire industry of aviation. So I see what's going on now as the dawn of an entire new marketplace where people can go joyriding, sure, as a kind of on holiday, but also people who can benefit from a new perspective. And by the way, politicians, we send them all first. They'll come back holding hands.
I love it. Well, they would bond. Yeah. I mean, that's actually quite a profound point, and that's the reason we asked you to be here. It's such a pleasure to get to talk to you.